I have to start by saying I've been a fan of yours my entire life, and it's an honestly, it's a real thrill to meet you.
Cool.
I just want to start with that. really, sincerely. One of the things that I think that people might be surprised about with Dolemite is that it's really dirty, but it's incredibly sweet at the same time.
It's dirty and sweet.
Right. So could you sort of talk about that aspect of it?
Well, because his material is really, really dirty. But we're doing the story about this, about how this guy got his records and his movies made, and you have to see the real person, you know. So there's some sweetness in it, the relationship that he has with Divine's character, Queen Bee, and his relationship with his friends and what he's trying to do. You know, there's a sweetness to that. You know, so you're seeing the real person. And lots of times people think that, most of the time people think that the person that you see on the screen or the person you see entertaining you is, that's who the person is. So you think that Rudy Ray Moore must be like a madman, but he really was a real person too.
Completely. What's amazing about this, about you playing Rudy, is that you have a long history with Dolemite being in your life, with you've hung out with Rudy many times. It has to be crazy to be playing him in a movie like this.
No, because I thought for years ago, I thought it would be a great idea for a movie. And I talked to him about it, and we could never get it to come together. I think it was because when I had the idea, I had just come off of like a movie like, I think, Pluto Nash or something. So, you know, then I'm at the studio going, I want to do the Rudy Ray Moore story. And they're like, what the fuck? So it just kind of never came together. But I still knew that the idea had merit. And then Netflix came into the world, you know.
Completely.
Yeah, and Netflix, this movie doesn't get made without Netflix.
I heard this crazy story, and I read it, and I don't know, that you, when you went in to meet with Ted and everyone at Netflix, you literally did Rudy in the room, and that was it. They were like, okay, go make that movie.
Well, yeah, because some people, the younger people, don't know who Rudy, a lot of people, Rudy Ray Moore is an underground artist, so a lot of people don't know who he is. So, you know, I was like, told him who he was, then I started doing some stuff, and they were like, oh, okay, that sounds like, that. I don't know who he is, but that shit you're saying right now is funny. So it's like, okay, then it kind of all came together. It all kind of came together.
I grew up watching you on SNL. I am overjoyed, like the entire world, that you're going to be going back in December.
Yeah, on the Christmas show.
I'm so excited. With SNL, because you've not been back to perform since you left, are you already thinking about like some of the things that you want to do, or is it sort of so far away, I'll think about it in November?
Yeah, you know, that show, really, you know, the show starts on Monday, and then on Saturday night, it's over at 1 o'clock in the morning, and then the week, you have one day off, then the week starts again with a brand new show, a brand new, so you can't really even go, okay, what will I do, what sketches, or start, because it doesn't start till you get there that Monday. You got to get there and meet those writers and meet everybody and then talk about, you know, what are you thinking about writing. So you can't be months away from, you can't, there's no way to prepare for that months out.
My last thing for you, and I got to go. I heard you might be doing Beverly Hills Cop 4.
Yeah, that's what we're doing after Coming to America. We're doing a Beverly Hills Cop, and then the plan is to get back on stage and do stand-up, and then kind of like, that's what I'll be doing mostly, is stand-up, and Beverly Hills Cop would be like the kind of like the, that's like, I keep saying it, this is more, these movies and Saturday Night Live, it's kind of like I'm looking at it as a bookend. And if I decide that I just want to stay on the couch forever, I ended it on a funny note, and I'll do stand-up. If I'm feeling creative, I can get on the stage and do my stand-up. And if, you know, some incredible filmmaker comes along with some great movie, or there's some great opportunity, but I'm not going to be making movies, you know, 2-3 a year like I did back in the early days now, because I like to just be home with the kids.
I've heard. Thank you so much. Yeah, you were fantastic in this. I wish you nothing but the best.
Oh, thanks, man.